Bob Rose is 96 years old and learned a thing or two about cattle working for the Diamond A Ranch.
I heard about these vast herds that are driven up here from Arizona through New Mexico. And to me, a vast herd any more than 400 or 500 is so damn hard to control.
Rose is one of a shrinking number of people who used to work for the Diamond A. They call him Young Bob. His father was Old Bob. Old Bob worked for the Diamond A for 67 years. He was working for the outfit even before the company established itself in South Dakota.
Well, my father worked with the Diamond A in Montana starting the 5th of July, 1912.
The Diamond A out of New Mexico and Colorado started leasing South Dakota land in 1907. In the early years, the outfit ran some 50,000 head of cattle on 1.4 million acres of rangeland, more or less centered on the town of Eagle Butte. Despite ownership and management changes, Diamond A managed to stay afloat through the 1950s and early 1960s. A few of the ranch's former employees established their own farms and ranches and still live in the area. It seems like everyone has a story about a time when things didn't go quite as planned.
One time at Ridgeview there, we just getting ready to brand. We had 500-600 head in the corral.
Yeah.
And I see Roy Hunt was, I think, the boss there. And I seen this trainer coming. I said, Roy, that train honks the horn before he gets to Ridgeview. Oh, he won't. You can see all these cows here, he won't. Sure as hell, he honked the horn. Them calves laid the south side of that corral, it's as flat as a pancake, they run for 5 miles.
Oh, yeah.
Then we got a saddle up and took us a week. We never did find them all.
Everett Hunt is from Eagle Butte and remembers a story his dad told him about a time when a guy riding a motorcycle on a nearby road spooked the herd they were working with.
They had gathered about 1,500 head of big steers. He said that 4- and 5-year-old steers hadn't seen a man, but once or twice in their life. And they trailed them up to Lantry and were going to load them on cars. And there was a big dry lake bed. So they bedded them and nighthawked them. And he said everything was going good and well. And in the train, they could hear the train coming in. And pretty soon here come a guy up over the hill with a motorcycle. And away went them steers. He said, we got them circled around, bedded down again. Here he came again. And Dad said that Tom Scoggins rode up to me and he said, Jack, you stay right here. If that son of a bitch comes by here again, your job is to rope him.
They say the pay was fair, the hours were sometimes long, but you might have to work at any time of day.
Yeah, we drove cows all night. It was hot, so we waited till dark, and them old cows knew they was going to the river anyway, so we trailed it down in the dark that night.
As for the cowboy persona, there's a lot of joking around, a lot of practical jokes. And if anyone offers you a cup of cowboy coffee, you might consider this story. Jim Holloway lives near Faith. His dad was a brand inspector back in the 40s, and Holloway remembers going to visit the Diamond A. While his dad talked outside with old Bob Rose, his mom decided to make some coffee in the ranch house.
Old Bob had the coffee pot on the back of the stove. Mother decided she ought to make coffee. Opened it up and it was dirty, so she went to throw it out and there's a dish rag in the bottom. She throwed it out, washed the pot out, put fresh water in and made coffee. A little while later, Bob come in and his coffee pot was cleaned and had coffee in it. And he said, ruined my coffee pot. Just ruined my God. Coffee pot.
Well, he would never throw the grounds out till the pot was full.
He'd get that much grounds in there for him.
Cowboy coffee.
Just cook them over and over. Yeah. Make better coffee that way.
Bob Rose can tell you the difference between a cowpoke and a cowpuncher and a saddle bum. He always thought he wanted to be a saddle bum.
A saddle bum was anybody that sat on a horse. And that's about all he was good for.
Rose also has an idea about what might get a cowboy labeled all hat, no cattle.
Some say that they talked about girls. That's all they wanted to do, was talk about girls when they were out on the range. And then when they got to town where there was liquor, they would go into the bar and all they would do is ride bucking horses.
To learn more about the Diamond A Ranch and hear more stories, check our website at sdpb.org/imagesofthepast.